seen Jesus, the light of the world, for them. You see, up to Jerusalem. It's a nice song, you like it. He said, I was glad when he said, show me. To the house of the Lord. You love coming to the house of the Lord?
Yes.
Amen. You learn so many things in the house of God, isn't it? Good. So,
thank you. Thank you.
was glad when they said to me, come to the house of the Lord. Okay? Can you sing? No music. Just clap your hands and sing. Okay, let's go.
I was glad when they said to me, come to the house of the Lord.
Oh, standing in the fence again. Thank you, Monsignor.
Oh, I was glad when he said to me, come to the house of the Lord.
Oh,
standing in the fence again.
Happy Jerusalem, happy Jerusalem. Jerusalem, peace. Jerusalem, please adorn Shalom.
Blessed be your voice, blessed be your.
I was glad when he said to me, come to the house of the Lord. Who's
standing in the presence
of heaven? Oh,
I was glad when he said to me, come to the house of the Lord.
Oh, standing in your place again,
after Jerusalem.
Sing your praise.
Sing your praise.
For this, let us read together. For this Melchizedek, king of Salem, priest of the Most High God, when woman Abraham returning from the slaughter of the kings and blessed him. To one also Abraham gave a tenth part of all, first being by interpretation king of righteousness, and after that also king of Salem, which is king of peace, without father, without mother, without descent, having neither beginning of days nor end of life, but made unto Son of God, abiding a priest continually. Amen. God bless you. May be seated.
Ministry which was had
three steps. He was the messenger in the seven short ages, and after that he was also a prophet. He had to open the book, okay? The book outside of the seven short ages. The book is not open here. We must come to the end of the ages, then the book will be open. Are you with me? So Balabala went out of the seven short ages to what we call the bright age. The bright age is when you see a pyramid. On the top of it, let me show you the pyramid here. Okay. You see a pyramid here. Okay? Are you with me?
Yeah.
Those ones, they are seven church ages, okay? Yeah. And this one is what we call the bright age. And the bright age, okay, is Jesus himself coming back in the form of a cloud. It's what we call the seventh seal. Are you with me? So the seventh seal is the mystery of the coming of the Lord. And God came again in this form again. So people was expecting Jesus to come back like this, but he came back in the form of the cloud. Because he was the cloud force, isn't it? He was a pillar of fire and the cloud. The pillar of fire and the cloud is just the same thing. He was with the children of Israel during the night as the pillar of fire, during the day as the cloud of glory. And after that, Jesus became a theophany to show himself to Abraham. And Abraham said that one day Moses said, I want to see you. The Bible says that Moses saw the back of God. Abraham said that it was a theophany. But today when he came, he didn't show only his back, he showed his face. The cloud, which is a theophany form of God, came also to reveal the words to us. You understand? And after this one, those seven messengers finished the work, Balaam had to go to this age, what we call the bright age, for the opening of the seals. Okay? After opening the seals, Balaam now united all the bride of Christ together in the opening of the word. Because that opening of the word, the opening of the seals, was what we call the book of redemption, which was calling all the people, the children of God, the predestinated children of God, to come to respond to the call. And Melchizedek, he met Abraham after the battle, isn't it? After the battle. And here, Abraham said that in the seven church ages, it was a battle. Also, as after the battle, we have to meet Melchizedek again. And who is Melchizedek? How do you recognize Melchizedek? You recognize Melchizedek according to what he did when he was on earth. What Melchizedek did? In Abraham's place, Melchizedek discerned the thoughts of the heart of Sam, isn't he? Yeah? So when Melchizedek comes back, so remember this. So when Melchizedek comes back, he's going to do the same thing. And Balaam preached a sermon called, who is this Melchizedek? It's a question. Not who was, but who is this Melchizedek? Balaam said that, you see, we come again to meet Melchizedek after the battle is over. The battle was in the seven short ages. God was looking to bring back his children in their normal position, original position. And because the body of Christ was deceived, like Eve during the church of the seven church ages, creeds and dogmas, they introduced something we called the denomination. That's why Balaam said that, I don't like the denomination. What the denomination is Balaam said that, is those people living in the past light, like people today, bring the message of John Wesley. It's not the message of the oil anymore. It's like the food you eat. When the food is not expired yet, it's good, it's going to give you life, isn't it? But if the food is expired, you know what is going to happen. You get so tiny, so and so. You understand? So you must eat the food in this season. But when I put you the message, it's called recognize your time and his message. Amen. But I'm not saying this about Melchizedek. I'm just trying to cut them from where to be started. You still remember, do you? Yeah? But I want to say that in a message to see Jesus, he said that now, if he's the same and is risen from death, living in his church, and he said, these things that I do, show you, do also. This one is John chapter 14. But Abraham said that, I know that you all believe in that. Amen. But Abraham said that, he was saying, I am the one who is concerned by this verse. Things that I do, you do also. It was Abraham himself. He said, in other words, that he said, I came from God, I go to God. Jesus was none other than Jehovah God. He was God the Father, revealed in human flesh. God the Father, revealed in human flesh. So the children of Israel, when they rejected Moses, they didn't want to reject Jehovah, isn't it? They didn't. They said, okay, we don't want Moses, but we want Jehovah. Rejecting Moses is rejecting God himself. You understand? Today you say, okay, I want Jesus, I don't want Balaam's message. Because Balaam's message is Balaam himself. You understand? Balaam said the message and the messenger are one. So, believing the message of Balaam is to believe in Balaam. God told him to record the message for people who come after. We start listening to the message. You understand? And that message is nothing else than the Lord Jesus Christ. So it is the message is the Lord Jesus Christ in the form of the word, which is coming to dwell in the people. So anything outside of this message is not Jesus. Jesus is not the name when people tell the name. Oh Jesus, it doesn't mean that's Jesus, isn't it? Because I can call this pulpit a car. Oh, this is my car. Is it making it a car? No. Jesus is the manifestation in each age. As I said, in every age, Jesus had a representation. In this age here, if you reject Paul, you reject Jesus Christ. You reject Arius, you reject Jesus Christ. And today, if you reject the child of God, you reject Jesus Christ. Himself. So the people that the reason the Bible says that, how can you love God whom you don't see? So you don't like your brother, but you love God. Most of the everybody love God, isn't it? Everyone asks everyone say, oh, I love God, but he failed to love his brother. You understand? But God is not there. But I don't say that the deity, God, is not in heaven anymore. So God is dwelling in his people. So people expecting to see God in heaven say, oh, one day when we die, we go to heaven, then we meet God. You go to heaven, you leave God here. The revelation, who God is. The salvation is to recognize God manifested in your age. Do you understand? The thief on the cross, he was there dying. Two of them, one of them said, oh, if you are the Messiah, why you don't save yourself? Come on. You are the Messiah. It has been spoken that the Messiah will come. If you are the one supposed to come, save yourself, then save us. Jesus Christ didn't say anything. But the other one said, he said, why do you talk to him like that? He said, this man didn't do anything wrong. You and me, we are guilty for doing wrongs. So we must die because we did wrong. But this man didn't do anything wrong. He said, oh Lord, when you be in paradise, please think about me. Don't forget about me. And Jesus looked at him. You see, if you got a bad expectation, you never even get the answer of God. But when you come in good expectation, God will speak to you. You notice that Jesus didn't speak to that guy. He ignored him, but he spoke to the other guy. He said, oh, this night you will be with me in the paradise. And the Bible says that that man, but the Bible said that he went to heaven. Why? Because he could recognize Jesus as the Jehovah God. So many people tell you that, oh, you believe Brother Branham, but we don't see the name of William Branham in the Bible. It's not a problem. The name of Brother Branham is everywhere in the Bible. Just look a little bit carefully, you see it. Amen. Even my name is in the Bible, isn't it? So Jewish people, they came and they told Jesus, and said, oh, Jesus, we don't see your name in the Bible. Jesus said, my name is there. What's your name? Say Isaiah 9. Amen. Amen. That's the way God identifying himself. God will never tell you, you go in the Bible, you find my name is so and so. No. They asked John the Baptist, said, who are you? Are you the Messiah? He said, no, I'm not the Messiah. Who are you? Are you one of the prophets? He said, no. They said, who are you? He said, I am the voice that cried in the wilderness. So John the Baptist was the prophecy, the fulfillment of the prophecy of Isaiah. He said, I sent a messenger before you to prepare my way. That was John the Baptist. And in the Old Testament, you never see the name of John. You never see the name of Jesus in the Old Testament. Amen? But the name of Jesus was there, and the name of John was there. The name, our names are written in form of history. That's the reason I say, if you want to find Barabbas in the Bible, you find him everywhere. Where do you see Barabbas' name in the Bible? Malachi chapter 4. Who's that? It's William Barabbas. You never see William Barabbas mentioned in the Bible, no. But he must identify himself in the Bible to show that I am the one who's supposed to come to bring the heart of the children back to God. Amen. Amen. So, the way you found yourself in the Bible is to find the scripture which is telling about you. And the Bible says that I'll send you, Elijah the prophet, I'll send you to you. Who's you? It's us. Everyone who receives Brother Branham as a messenger, the you concern that person. So I am in the Bible, you found me in Malachi chapter 4. So you don't expect to find to see the name of Eric Malonga in the Bible, because that's not my name. The Bible says all the families from heaven and earth is called Jesus. Jesus is family name. Amen. Amen. So if you don't see God in your age, that's what sin is. And Melchizedek was one of the manifestations, and he said that he's going to come again to be manifested in this age. That's Melchizedek. Amen. Amen. He said, God dwelt in him like the Holy Spirit dwells in us today. God was dwelling in Jesus Christ like the Holy Ghost is dwelling in us today. Amen. And the Son of God was submissive. To the Father. And a servant of God today is submissive to the Father. Who's the Father? The Lord. Amen. Are you free? So Jesus, but I want to say that Jesus cannot be one with the Father as my finger. Jesus was one with the Father because he was in agreement with the Father. Okay. The body was Jesus of Nazareth, but the spirit inside of him was the Father. Same thing today. The body, your body, is you. The body, which is the seat of your parents. But the spirit in you is part of himself. Is what makes you a God. Is from what you understand things of God. You understand? But the Baron speaking said, he promised that in these last days, there will be a lettering put out upon the people. In the last days, I think the Greek word there is kinos, which means that he emptied himself out, not in the way that we would say, like something was inside of somebody that he emptied out, but he pulled himself out, is what I said last time. God here, okay? And this is Jesus, okay? God put himself in Jesus, in what we call kinos, yeah? What God is doing is changing his form. It's no longer here, it's now here. Okay? When it's changing from this form to this one, is what we call N. What is that? N morph. Okay? Changing the form. It changes the form by kinos. You understand? So that means that it didn't form it like I emptied something from my mouth like and I'm still here. But I said no. He said everything was God changed the form now. Instead of to see here Jehovah, okay? He changes his form, he became Jesus Christ. And this one doesn't exist anymore. He became Jesus. And after that, Jesus did also the same. He put himself now to the blind, okay? And this one doesn't exist any longer. In kinos system, okay? That means God has changed the form again. From this form to this one. It's no longer here, it's this one. What you see, what we call the bread of Christ is the Lord Jesus, okay? Which Jesus is it? I said there was Jesus in Jesus, isn't it? Jesus. Because Jesus, the Father, okay? This Jesus, the Son. The Father was in the Son, okay? And the Son is not there anymore, but this Jesus here is what we call Melchizedek, still there. Because he didn't die. This Jesus here died on the cross, isn't it? He died and resurrected. But this one never died. He's the one still living. He's the same Jesus changing that form. And when he was here in Jesus, he was Jesus. He came in Jesus of Nazareth, he was Jesus. And now in the bride, he's still the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
So the body has changed. And Melchizedek was this one supposed to come to the end time to reveal himself after the battle is over.
Mm.
Are you feeling?
Yeah.
Is it hard, Sister Rebecca? Okay. Yeah, good. So today, the same Jesus changed the form. But I want to say that this one is called kinos when he changed. He put himself inside of something. He changed the form. The morphed God who changes the form. You understand? The same God was Moses, and after that he wasn't Moses anymore. He became Jesus. And Jewish people, they had this the same problem. When they saw Jesus, Jesus asked them, who do you say I am? They said that, some people they said that you are Moses. Some people they said that you are Elijah. So they thought Jehovah is only Moses, is only Elijah. But now Jehovah, which is Jesus, wasn't Elijah or Moses anymore, he became Jesus of Nazareth. And they told him that you are a man, you are trying to make yourself a God. You understand? Because he said, I am the Son of God. If I say I'm a son of God, who I am? Who am I? God. Amen. The little lion is a lion, isn't it? Everything is inside there. When you grow up, it's going to be a big lion. What is small is it looks like a cat. Amen. You can take him home, and baby him, give him milk. But it's a lion. That little lion, how do you call the little lion?
It's a cow.
A cow. That little cow is a lion. So it's just demanding time. Day by day, and then it's a small one. You can beat him if you want. But one day after a couple of years, he's going to eat you. Because inside of him, he's got the character of a lion. Whatever, how small it is, but it's a lion. You understand? But when it's small, you take the cats here, they can't even fight. Even maybe if the cat can win because it's small, but let him grow up a little bit. It's going to become big like here. Have you seen a lion before? We went to the zoo one day, we saw a lion. You understand? Now, the children of God stay the same. You are just little Joseph like this, little prince. He's a small boy. But inside of him is God. Just give him the word of God. Train him in the word of God, and then you see he's going to be powerful like God. But I want to say that the power which caused the world in existence is living in human being. It's living in you. That big power, the pillar of fire, is living in human being. So if you understand your position, now you stand against Satan. Satan cannot do anything against you. The thing is, Satan is trying to pull you away from the word of God. That's his strength. The only way he can do is to pull you away from the word of God for you to never recognize your position. Then Satan will be strong. Once you recognize that you are a small lion, you give yourself time, and until you grow up, then Satan can't do anything against you. And once Satan will understand that, you understand your position, you run away from him. Because you become very dangerous. You understand? So Melchizedek came now, but I want to say that when Melchizedek came, he came to give us a part of himself. Amen. If you see, everything you eat is what you become. Yes? If you eat fufu, you become it. If you stop eating, you die, isn't it? So everything you eat every day is what is making your body. If you eat pondo, you become pondo. Even me, I'm standing here. I don't care how tall I am, but I'm just pondo. Fufu, everything together. What I'm eating, isn't it? If I stop eating, what's going to happen? I'm going to become slave. And then I'll die. Because there's no food. But I want to say the food is what is feeding your body. And spiritually speaking, when you're eating the word of God, it's helping you to grow up. To have muscles, spiritually speaking. But I want to say that he saw one day a big man in the vision was beating the woman. He said, that woman seems to be like my mother. And when I saw the man, he was so big and big muscles, I said, I can't help that woman. But that man was beating that woman too much. He said, no, I must go there. He said, once I go there, I was supposed to see my muscles become bigger than this man's muscles. And he touched that man here. He said, stop beating this woman. And what he saw, brother, that man was afraid of you. He said, what is that? He said, it's the muscles of the word of God. More what you eat, more bigger you get spiritually.
Amen.
If you don't eat, you shrink. Read your Bible and pray every day, and you grow. So don't read your Bible and don't pray every day, then you shrink. Satan will never be afraid of you. You understand? Melchizedek is God himself coming in the form of the word to to give a part of himself to us. Amen. So when we come in, when you're eating the word of God, you become the word of God. And the word of God is nothing else than God himself. So when you'll be walking on the street, it's God walking. But I want to say that God doesn't have hands to touch something. If God wants to touch something, he's going to use your hands. If God wants to speak, he's going to use your mouth. If God wants to think, he's going to use your body. So your body must be in submission to God for God to walk through you. Are you free? Praise God. So God put himself in the system of kinos to involve himself, to change the form from Jesus Christ to become Barabbas, and from Barabbas to become Barabbas Israel. Do you believe it? To become Barabbas Aaron, to become Barabbas Joel, to become Barabbas Joseph. That's what Jesus Christ is. And today, Jesus Christ must be recognized in the people. Are you with me? So it changed his morph. He changed from what he was to what he is. Do you understand? That's what we call him off. He changed from what he was. And this one, you see, even people in the message, they fail to understand this. But when I'm trying to make the message so simple for everyone to understand, he changed from what he was to what he is. So he's no longer there. He's no longer what he was. Jesus of Nazareth is no longer there. Simple than that. He became the messenger, he became Paul, he became Avenues, he became Columba, Martin, so on and so forth, until he became Barabbas. And today, the same Jesus of Nazareth became you and me. How can you expect to see Jesus? Said, one day, the world will see me no more, but you will see me. Because I'll be with you even in me. Amen. Why? Because you are the representation of God in this earth. Amen. Jesus knew that he said that, should I found faith when I be back? It's hard to find Jesus in your time. And Abraham, he had enough faith to see God coming into his house. He said, don't pass by, sit there, let me get water to wash your feet. Amen. Let me get water to wash your feet. Don't go. Let me tell my wife to prepare something for you to eat. And God sat down. God ate. Amen. God can eat. Yes. God can eat. God can wash feet. He was Melchizedek to Abraham. And after the battle, he came to Abraham again. He said, you are the overcomer. Let me come to you, give you communion, because you are the overcomer. You've got victory. Amen. Amen. But one day of Pentecost, he changed himself from being the Son of Man to the Son of God. What the Son of God means? The Son of God means the pillar of fire.
Amen.
This one, that's what he called the Son of. He was the Son of God, which means the prophet. The Son of God, which means the prophet, he became the Son of God, which means the pillar of fire. Why? To the seven church ages. Son of God. To Israel, he was the Son of Man, prophet. To the Gentile, he was the Son of God, and he must come back again as the Son of Man. As a prophet. To where? God says that I will visit you, you must expect the prophet. You understand? That's why we sing the song, Le Grand Jour s'est levé, Dieu nous a visité. God visited us. People singing that, still expecting for Jesus to visit them. Amen. Le Grand Jour s'est levé, Dieu nous a visité. The great day has risen, God has visited us. So, the Messiah, what the Messiah is going to do? When the Messiah comes, he will discern the fault of the heart of people. Amen. Amen. So, if we are expecting another Messiah to come, what is going to do? Because every work has been done. Are you with me? says, he came not with the people, he came in the people. I like that. See, the same God to carry his ministry or through in this brief age. And the title is The Mighty God Unveiled Before Us. You understand? Unveiled, what does that mean? God was veiled, isn't it? He was veiled like this. He was like this. Nobody can see him. When they say the mighty God unveiled, that means the veil is taken off. Now we can see God. How do you see God? But Abraham said that, I'm expecting for the nail scars. He said, no. I'm expecting someone to come with a war. But Abraham said, no. Or what? With, I don't know, with long hair, with beard. But Abraham said, no. He said, when you come, you do exactly the same thing he did when he was here. So now, if you want to know if Jesus has come or not, you must now try to understand what he did in his first coming. And he's going to do exactly the same. That's the way to recognize him. Don't expect a man with robe, a man with beard to come here. Because he has changed. Listen, that's the way, but I want to say that's the way God made people to scratch their heads. They won't see it. So if Jesus comes in this position, even unbelievers, people in the nightclub, they will recognize him, isn't it? Because all the world knows this one. You know, we've got so many pictures of Jesus, but most of the pictures they look alike. Most of them. So Jesus is no longer this. He came today contrary to this one. So Jesus started from here, he finishes there.
Amen.
Understand? When Paul was there, it was Jesus. And you come in this age, because if Jesus comes today, we must dress like the people of this day. Right? I mean, if we retire today, when Jesus comes, we must retire. Cut properly his hair, and to look like this one. You say amen on that?
Amen.
Don't look the appearance of person, how it looks like. Look for this one. Because this one, when he met Paul, he said, I am Jesus Christ. So my Bible said that when I was born, this one came in the Lord's cabin, and this one was dwelling in him. What is this? The Lord Jesus. What is dwelling in this man? What is that? It's the Lord Jesus Christ. They said that, oh, big Jehovah, which was coming down on the top of the mountain, cannot live in such man. He's too small. He was just a simple man, but in him was dwelling Jehovah, the fullness of God. You understand? Today, everyone is praising this man here because they don't know about him. He was rejected the same way as this one was rejected. The same Lord Jesus Christ, the pillar of fire, was dwelling in him. The same one came in him. The same one is dwelling in us. Man. Is God kenos in himself, in his people, changing their forms. Is it not? Amen. He came in the people, see, the same God to carry his ministry on through in this real age. God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself. I have explained this word. Amen. Yeah, I did. Reconciliation. Yeah. Who can tell me what that means? Reconciliation. Fix the problem. You have trouble with someone, then you fix it. You are doing reconciliation. So God had a problem with us. How? Through our father Adam. So Adam was separated from God. God now started a redemption to bring Adam back for the reconciliation between God and us. You understand? So God came in Christ to reconcile the world, the people, with himself. He said, I came from God, said Christ, and I go back to God. Indeed, it's God all along, only three offices. The fatherhood, sonship, the Holy Ghost, his possession, is all the self-same God. The fatherhood was with Moses, and the sonship with Jesus, and the Holy Ghost dispensation is in time of God. And then you see, he comes right down the regular line from attribute to before the creation of the world. His name is put on the Lamb's book of life. Then, from that, he began that could appear, disappear, and then he became flesh and returned back again, resurrected that same body in the glorified condition. The same Jesus. He came, he became flesh, he died, he went back to that form again. Amen. I'm closing soon. In the message called what is this Melchizedek? Balaam said, code number 68. Now, the difference between him and you as a son. See, he was at the beginning, the word, and a morph body. He came in and lived in that, in the person of Melchizedek. Then later, we never heard no more of Melchizedek because he became Jesus Christ. Melchizedek was the priest. But he became Jesus Christ. Now you bypass that. The theophany for you bypass that. Jesus came from God, theophany, and then flesh. But you came from God as attribute straight away to the flesh, the mystery of theophany. And the reason you need faith to believe. Okay? You come like Adam, like me. You became from the attribute of flesh to be tempted. But when this life is finished here, if this earthly tabernacle, this body, be dissolved, we die. Okay? We have one already waiting. What is that? Your theophany, your glorified body. Still there, but Abraham said that it's there, it's waiting. How do you know? You believe because the word says. Amen. That's where we go. That's in the word. Then we can look back and see what we've done. You see, when Sister Sharon Rose died after her death, but when I went to beyond the curtain of time, okay? When he had a vision, he went beyond the curtain of time. He met his daughter, Sister Sharon Rose. And Sister Sharon Rose could recognize him, but she said, I am your daughter. I said, no, my daughter was a baby. He said, Dad, here, there's no babies. Because Sister Sharon was not in that body, she could recognize what took place. But I want to say that the death doesn't change your nature. The death just changes your dwelling place. You come from this earthly body, and you go to your glorified body, which is theophany, the same body of Melchizedek. So Melchizedek, what is coming back, is bringing also the bodies, the bodies of the earth for you. Once this one is destroyed, one is there waiting for you. But when I said that, Jesus said, I go to prepare a place for you. When I come back, I will bring you with me. I'll take you with me. Amen. And my mom said, when Jesus said that, by saying that it wasn't houses, said God doesn't build houses. Said he went to prepare bodies. So everything you are here, it's represented somewhere. You are living in connection with that representation. That's where we go. That is the word. Amen. Then we can look back and see what we done. Now we don't understand it. We have never become the Word. We've just became the flesh man, not the Word. So we bypassed our theophany. Jesus didn't bypass it. The man who came to visit Abraham was Jesus Christ, but in other form, not Jesus of Nazareth. Jesus came from God, from attribute to the theophany and then flesh. But you and me came from attribute to the flesh, we bypassed our theophany. Do you understand? But you bypassed the theophany and became fleshman to be tempted by sin. Amen. And then, if this earthly tabernacle is dissolved, we have one already waiting. We have not yet the bodies of the bodies. As you know, two forms, you are in flesh. This flesh here is not you. The through you is there, gene of God. Okay? This one is earthly, that one is heavenly. This one is flesh, that one is theophany. This one is imperfect. You'll never be perfect in this body. Impossible. Your perfection is there. As long as you are the seed of God, you came from God, since your birth, you stay perfect. But what I'm saying that God cannot save you now and you get lost after tomorrow. So once God saves you, He saves you forever. You can make mistakes, but you still save. This one is mortal, it's going to die. Amen. There's no redemption for this one. This man here for flesh cannot go to heaven. The heaven wasn't meant for him. He must die. God is mortal. Mortal means something had beginning and had finished. Amen. Sinless, this one sinless, but this one born in sin. But Abraham said that we born in sin. I saw a little Chinese boy, he was stealing money. Did you see him? Someone said it to me. That boy was stealing money. Take me money, put it in your pocket. A little boy. That boy never go to university to learn how to steal. Amen. But he knows how to play. Because sin is in this world. That's why the Bible says that this one is born in sin, but that one is sinless. So, this one is through you, the true you, and this one is not you. This one is your representation. So, this one doesn't matter about this one, but the problem is about this. Do you understand? This one will say God. Say, lives by the word. This one, loves the world, things of the world. You understand? This one is written in the Lamb's book of life. This one is written in the book of life. God knows about you. But this one will go. God will take it off. But this one, God will never be gone. Because it is in the books, Lamb's book of life. This one possesses the Zoe life, but this one needs the new birth. This one is wrong because this one cannot be born again. Impossible. The new birth is to recognize your position. Zoe life. This one is really in this. And he said, the real you, and who's this? The negative of you. So everything against you is against this man. And Barbara said that this man is the enemy of this man. It's a fighting. It's a fight. It's a fight. So when you're fighting, you're not fighting against me. You're fighting against yourself. You understand? This here is fighting this one. Paul said, I want to do good, but the evil is coming to me. So you must fight. That's why we spoke about influence. You are in the school. Someone says, let's do this. You say, oh, no. Let's do this. You do this. You say, no. It's a fight. It's a fight in the mind. Amen. Now, we are part of God. You always was. Amen. You don't remember it because you were only an attribute in God. Before your birth, was in your father's. Can you remember? Do you remember when you was in your father? No, you don't. Do you? But you've been taught. And when you see the science told you that it was like that. And you believe it isn't. It's the same when we were in God. You can't remember, but the word told us that we've been in God and we must say amen to that. You understand? Because you are part of God, you can't get lost. You understand? You are only in his speaking, your very name, if it ever was on the book of life, it was put there before the foundation of the world. He knew what you were, okay? I'm only saying this not to mix up doctrine, but to straighten it out, that we might get away from this fear and scare. You don't know who you are, you are not going to be, but now you are the sons of God. See, you always were the sons of God. You don't become the son of God when you believe. You are the son of God before, even to be born. Amen. For when God had you in his thinking, at the beginning, you have to be. You have to be some part of you. Your life that's in you now had to be with God before death. Well, before he even became material, he on earth, before there was anything but God, you were one of his attributes. He knew what your name would be. He knew the color of your hair. The color of your hair, he knew the color of hair you would have. He knew all about you. The only thing happened is when you bent a sinner. So God knew exactly everything about you. So God is not surprised. God knew exactly everything. He knew what you're going to be, what you're going to do. Amen. Why? You don't know because we bypass that to your friend. Now, Melchizedek came to ask today after the battle to give back the word of God which came to tell us who we are. You understand? The word of God is about the recovery of the identity, who I am. That's the reason you must not be like everyone in the street. You are special people. You understand? You are special people. You walk as gods. Because you are not human, you are gods. Amen. You are God. So everything you do, you must think and know that you are God manifested in human flesh. Because you have met Melchizedek. How do you believe it? Because you are the seed of Abraham. In the same way Abraham recognized Melchizedek, and today we saw Melchizedek manifested himself in the body of William Branham, speaking of preaching out to us and to us the word of God to give that body back to us again. Who is Melchizedek? It's the same one who met Abraham. And today the same Melchizedek came to meet the seed of Abraham is what? Yeah. Amen. God bless you. Amen. You have any questions? Any questions? What you say, I am. And once you say it again, thank you. Clear understanding of the scripture as we're coming ourselves to you in the precious name of Jesus Christ.